Look quite like this, but it has the congregational responses on it, and that you're in reach of a hymn book which will be somewhere jotted about on a shelf in front of you or hidden under the chair on the side or somewhere. And welcome to those of you watching at home. Again, there is a leaflet available on, there should be a link at the bottom of the YouTube description or on our church webpage, but if you haven't got it, just follow along the best you can. I'm just really glad that we're able to reach you at home and have you worshiping with us. And if you're my mother, happy American Mother's Day today. It's American Mother's Day today. My dad called me last night and said, "What are you doing?" I said, "I'm a phony mom." But I'm also saying hello to her on the internet, so there we go. Thank you to those of you who supported our coronation Thanksgiving service at Christ the King last week. We are still also celebrating Easter season, wearing white, and looking towards Pentecost and then Trinity. So we've got a prayer as we look towards Pentecost. Would you join with me in this prayer? Come,
Holy Spirit, Fill the hearts of your faithful people, and kindle in us the fire of your love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. We're going to turn in these little red books to hymn number 372. It's not a page number, it's a hymn number. 372, and sing Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise. 372. Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Receiving forgiveness, we stand. The words for this next bit are in your leaflets, not in the hymn book. We sing Glory to God.
Thank you. with just a moment of silent prayer before our collect prayer. Let us pray. God, our Redeemer, you have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. Grant that as by his death he has recalled us to life, so by his continual presence in us, he may raise us to eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Would you please be seated? Have we got any children who would like to go out to do the disciples? I don't think we have this morning. Hopefully. No. No. we'll take a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. I might call on Colin. Thank you.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Paul stood in front of the Areopagus, and said, Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found among them an altar with the inscription, To an unknown God. What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you. The God who made the world and everything in it, he who is Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands, as though he needed anything, since he himself gives to mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor, he made all nations to inhabit the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of places where they should live, so that they would search for God and perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as even some of your own poets have said, for we too are his offspring. Since we are God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed, and with this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Next hymn in your red books is number 220, Jesus Shall Reign, Where'er the Sun Does His Successive Journeys Run, number 220.
John is a theologian. For John, the church is above all a community of believers and a community of love. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. Those who receive my commandments and keep them, that's who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them. As Christians, then, we are called to be a community of love. Those of you who use the Daily Prayer at Home leaflets will find over the next couple of weeks or so that the readings will take you through the whole of John's first letter, where he teases out this idea a lot more. It is a challenge for us, a challenge to explore ever deeper what does it mean to be a community of believers and a community of love. Above all, John challenges us to love Jesus, and through him to love the Father, and to receive the Holy Spirit, to say yes to God, and to love one another, to be a community, to be generous to one another in the gifts of the Spirit, to understand and accept and celebrate that we all have different gifts, different limitations, different responses to difficult questions. So the whole debate around living in love and faith, for example, or to the monarchy. So many different ways in which each of us are able to act out our Christian faith. But in our differences, we nonetheless belong together. But being a community has practical consequences as well. To be a functional community, we have to organise our communal life. And that's what the structures of the church are there for. Why do we have dioceses and parishes? In order to have an institutional framework that enables us to gather together in the Eucharist, for fellowship, and for outreach to the world around us. And in order to function effectively, the church needs resources of many kinds, staff, and buildings, and equipment. And you may have guessed where this is going, that all costs money. During May, we are particularly focusing on how we can fund our parish more effectively and sustainably, so that our parish can be a well-functioning community of love. Many of you have already responded to our campaign to reorganize how each of us can contribute to what we can afford by switching over to the parish giving scheme. Thank you. Thank you for a marvellous response to this. But for anyone who hasn't switched yet and wants to, in this week's bulletin you will find instructions how to do it by phone, and you'll find the QR code where you can do it with a smartphone. And we have ordered more copies of the leaflets for those who want to fill out a form and send it by post. They've been on the way for over a week and they haven't arrived yet. For those of you who are not comfortable in making this kind of switch, thank you, too, for the ways that you contribute. Because we need those funds. For example, here at Trinity Church, the PCC wants to install a proper pull-down ladder to give better access to the loft where we store all kinds of things that aren't used week by week. And this will cost the best part of £1,000. And it's great to have Stephen playing the organ for us. He's going to be here next week. But what we'd love to have, of course, is a regular organist and director of music. But a musical director has to be paid. It's not an easy time to be tackling this question with inflation pushing prices up and up. I have followed how the price of Tesco soup has very nearly doubled in the last 12 months. It's one of the large staples. Many people in the NHS, in the rail industry, teachers, have turned to strikes in order to drive it home that it isn't sustainable to allow people's purchasing power just to be whittled away through austerity. So this is not an easy time to be asking for more money. And yet we need to, because the church is hit by inflation as well. The heating costs for this church have gone up quite dramatically, just as everybody else's heating costs have. And that's why the parish giving scheme allows you, if you tick that box and you don't have to automatically inflation-proof your contributions. There was a story some 20 years ago, I think, about someone who, when this country decimalized its currency in 1973, then they rethought how much they needed to put in the collection. And 20 years later, they realized they were still putting the same amount in. But of course, they were not still putting the same value in. So inflation proofing does make sense. So thank you, all of you, for all that you do, because we share this responsibility to make sure that our parish, this parish, can be a well-functioning, well-funded community of love. May the words of my lips and the thoughts of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Amen.
In your leaflets, you'll find the creed, which begins, "We believe in one God." I invite you, as you're able, to stand and we declare the faith of the church together. We believe in one God,
the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Would you please be seated? I publish the banns of marriage between Carl Bull of this parish and Stephanie Elaine White, also of this parish. This is for the second time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why they may not marry each other, you are to declare it. Thank you. We're going to pray for them as we're led in our prayers of intercession, and also I've taken off of that little prayer tree over there the prayers that have been made during the week. I'm going to put these on the altar so we're remembering these prayers, Stephanie and Carl, and whoever else soon leads us in as we pray together.
And so we pray for the church and for the world, and we thank God for his goodness. Heavenly Father, we do indeed thank you for your goodness. And in this season of Easter, we thank you for Jesus' life, death, and resurrection. We thank you, Father, for the salvation and life in you that he brought us. We thank you for your merciful love for us. Heavenly Father, as we pray for the Church, we pray for Christians worldwide who are being persecuted and oppressed because of their faith in you. And we pray, Father, that you will uphold and strengthen them in their faith and give them the courage and hope that they need. Heavenly Father, we ask for your blessing upon our bishops, Alan, Richard and Jane, upon our ministry team, Ruth, Andy, Keith, Clive, Glynis, and all those who have positions of responsibility in Holy Trinity and Christ the King. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And Heavenly Father, we thank you for Roberta's ministry in keeping the church clean for some years, and ask for your blessing upon her as she begins a new phase in her life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the reign of King Charles III and Queen Camilla, and pray that you will bless them with wisdom, fortitude, and compassion. We pray for the members of our government, and pray that they will govern with integrity and the well-being of the British people at heart. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the beauty and diversity of your creation, and we pray that each one of us will do what we can to be good stewards of your world and its resources. We pray, Father, that we would work with you in sustaining and maintaining the beauty and well-being of all you have created. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we pray for all who live and work in our parish, and especially for those who come into this church during the week. We pray, Father, that they would meet with you and know your love for them. We ask for your blessing upon all whom we love, all who love us, and we pray that we may serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, in the book of Exodus we read that you promise, I am the Lord who heals you. And so, Father, we claim your promise and ask for healing for Anna, Christine, Richard, Fortuna, Eddie and Basil, Pauline, Barbara, Linda, Tanya, Peter, Rebecca, Sam and Evelyn, Angela, Tony, Larry, Romeo, Claire, Malcolm and Cheryl, Michelle, Jean, Brendan, Pauline and Teresa, Ian and John. And in a moment of silence, we pray for people whom we know who are in need of prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for healing in body, mind and spirit for these people for whom we pray. And we ask that they would know the peace of your presence with them today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the lives of those whose year's mind forms this week. And in particular, for Edgar Borman, Kate Cope, and Joan Brooks. And we pray for the repose of the souls of those who died this past night, especially those who died afraid, alone, in despair, or in violent circumstances. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we conclude with a prayer of St. Ignatius of Loyola. Grant, O Lord, that your love may so fill our lives that we may count nothing too small to do for you, nothing too much to give, and nothing too hard to bear. For Jesus Christ's sake, Amen. Amen.
As you're able, I'd like to stand for peace. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, peace be with you. Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And to share a sign of peace with you.
More and more people are giving through this parish giving scheme, but we do always have a plate out, and we bring this forward, which represents also all gifts that we make in other ways. And we have a collection of practical items for those in need in our community who can go to the food shed. Bless these gifts and bless the gifts. Amen. Lord, bless these gifts and those who will receive them. Amen. We're going to sing hymn number 331. O Jesus, I have promised, this is in your red books, but we have the recorded music, so we don't have quite enough verses. We're going to skip verse 2. We skip verse 2, but sing, O Jesus, I have promised, number 331. From this service today to those who are not able to be here in person are Glynis and Derek, and they're taking this Sunday communion to Louis Richards, Valerie Lines, and Sybil Graham. So we're grateful for that ministry of Glynis and Derek and others who do it on other Sundays, and for these people who are keeping in touch with us even though they're not able to be here in person. If that's something you would be interested in, for example, if you're watching from home, do let us know. Thank you. The Lord is here.
Yes.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God.
faith and words of hope. He touched untouchables with love and washed the guilty clean. This is his story.
Oh,
Holy Communion ever, if you have been confirmed, if you regularly receive communion in another Christian church, you're very welcome to receive with us. We invite everyone, whether that's true or not, if you would like, to come forward to the altar step where sin is for a blessing, and or to receive communion. If you're receiving a blessing rather than communion, if you're not receiving communion, you can just put your arm on your shoulder or carry your leaflet or something to signal that that's the case. It's also just okay to stay in your pew. If you're at home, there's a prayer of spiritual communion to pray in the leaflet. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God our Father, whose Son Jesus Christ gave the water of eternal life, may we thirst for you, the spring of all life and source of goodness, through him who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. You have opened to us the scriptures, O Christ, and you have made yourself known in the breaking of the bread.
Abide with us, we pray, that blessed by your royal presence, we may walk with you all the days of our life, and at its end to behold you in the glory of the eternal Trinity, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Before we finish our service, I have a few notices. Trivia question. What is the name of the principal feast of the church when our risen Jesus returned to heaven in a cloud? There you go. That's two announcements in one. One is that there's a Friends of Holy Trinity quiz night on Friday, and Bob, give us a wave. And Karen, give us a wave. Is Karen here today? No, it's just Bob. You need to sign up with Bob to be part of a team. He can put you in a team if you don't have one, or bring a team for the quiz night. And the other announcement is, yes, Ascension Day is on Thursday, and we're having a Eucharist here at noon, and I'm hoping to do it outside. So if you, it should be only a half an hour long, but if that's too long to be standing, bring a folding chair or a stool or whatever. Or you can sit on a bench in the churchyard, but it'd be better if you can bring a chair. We are pushing the parish giving scheme. The little code is there. Mary's willing to take your name if you're one of the people who's hoping for a form to fill out and put in the post. Mary, give us a wave. Because we ordered them in plenty of time, we should have had more. And bring your little plastic bits, if you've done it with the form, bring your plastic bits on the 21st. We'll pile them all into a basket and see how we're doing. If we've got 85 people, this is a very high target, I'm now realizing, but this is what I said. If we get 85 people signed up, I'll bring bubbly on Trinity Sunday. So, you know, go up and down your street to your neighbors, say, would you be willing to support this great building in our old town for £1 a week or something? Would you sign up? Even £20 a year. We want to get 85. If we get 100 people signed up, I will dance a Morris jig outside the Coach and Horses pub. I actually have a musician lined up with the squeeze box who said, oh yeah, I'll go for that. Two of the Morris dancers on my side have said they might sign up to the parish giving scheme just to see me dance a jig outside the pub. So that's the plan. Roberta, we've said I'm not going to make you stand up in front of everybody. Mary and Glynis and I are going to come to you. We want to thank you for the care you've given to this building, which has been a blessing to us and a service to God. We want to give you this candle, which I forgot to pick up. You give her a plant and a card that everybody signed, and I should fetch the candle. We've got a candle with our parish logo on it that we give to people who are leaving us. Yes, please do. Please do. That's all right. Come on, say thank you. We're thanking you, really.
Can I just say, next Friday will be the last time I kept clean this beautiful church. It truly has been my pleasure. I came here just under 11 years ago because they needed cleaners. I thought I'd do it for a few weeks. Obviously, the time's gone on. It's given me so much pleasure. When I come here in the care, I sing away and do my cleaning. It gives me so much solace because of the losses. I love working with Glynis in the breakfast club, so I hope that continues one day. And Ruth, when you came to see me in hospital, when I got knocked out by that van coming to work. I'd just like to say a big thank you. Even though I'm going to North it, I mean, sadly I lost my baby dog on Thursday. He's over 15 years old. But I just want to say a big thank you to the Holy Trinity, and you're so lucky to have this place to come to. Thank you.
Let us pray. Father of mercy, guide us all in the way of righteousness before you. Continue, we pray, your loving kindness to Roberta. Keep far from her and her family all manner of shame, grief, and care. And grant that peace, light, and joy ever abide in her new home. For with you is the fountain of life, and in your light do we see light. Amen.
Amen.
I hope you're staying to coffee. I hope everybody is staying to coffee. Just in the room next door, we've got tea and coffee and probably squash, and sometimes we have biscuits and even cake. I think probably today's a biscuit day. We're going to sing our final hymn, number 243. Christ is our cornerstone. 243.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Christ.